Are you able to see everybody? You're able to see? Right, okay.
So this is called darpana prakriya. Darpana means mirror.
Okay. Prakriya means a process. A prakriya is a process of teaching the Vedanta Atmajnana. So darpana prakriya, first let us understand. Okay. So let us imagine that you are sitting in a rocket and going in outer space. And there is a sun behind you. And if you look from the window, what will you see? Will you see darkness or light? Actually, you'll see complete darkness. There'll be no light because the sunlight cannot be seen by the naked eyes. Sunlight requires a reflecting surface. In the outer space, there's no reflecting surface. Because there's no reflecting surface, you see outside the window, you'll see only darkness. So in Earth, you'll see the sunlight. Because the sunlight falls on the dust particles in the air and it gets reflected. That's why we see the reflected light. Consciousness is similar, something similar to that. The consciousness of Chaitanyam or the Atma is all pervading. There's no way we can experience it or see it. To see the consciousness or experience the consciousness, it needs a reflecting surface. It needs a surface to reflect. Without the reflecting surface, this consciousness cannot be seen. So the reflecting surface is the object of the world, Maya. So somebody asked the question, why Maya is there? Because the consciousness presence can be seen only in the presence of Maya. Maya is the reflecting surface. Only then we can understand there's a consciousness. So the consciousness is Chetana and the world is matter, object, is Jada. So when the Chaitanya, the consciousness falls on the matter, Jada, there's a reflection. In the reflection, we can see the presence of the consciousness. Otherwise, you cannot know the consciousness is there. So matter, what we can see as a matter, what we call as matter, physical matter, has form. Form includes touch, sound, smell, taste, and feel. So these are the forms of the matter. Consciousness has no form. When the consciousness gets reflected on the matter, you become conscious of that form. Just like sunlight, sun, presence of sun is known only if there is a reflection of sunlight on an object. The consciousness is known only when the object is present. That object becomes a reflecting surface for the consciousness. So let us take what we call as Sakshi. Or the consciousness. Sakshi is the inner self. Sakshi is what I am. Brahman is the universal consciousness. Sakshi and Brahman are one and the same. So the light of the Sakshi gets reflected on the mind. The mind is the mirror. Mind becomes the reflection, reflecting surface, mirror. And the secondary reflection of the mind falls on the body, and third reflection falls on the world. The sun represents the sakshi, the witness. So the primary reflection is the mind. The mind I have shown as a mirror. The consciousness gets reflected here. So the mind becomes alive. Then there is a feeling of I am. So this is exactly what happens when you wake up in the morning. In deep sleep, there is no mind. Only consciousness is there. When you wake up, the mind comes up. There's a reflection called I am in the mind. So then the reflection of that falls on the body, secondary reflection. Then the body appears. So then through sense organs get illuminated, and through sense organs, reflection falls on the world. So the world appears. The first reflection is the mind, second reflection is the body, and third reflection is the world. So, body becomes alive, and the consciousness, awareness falls on the world through the sense organs. So reflection is only one, chidabhasa. The reflected light makes body alive, otherwise body is dead matter, body is inert. And senses become alive, and through senses, the awareness flows into the world. Right? So now, this reflection on the mind is called chidabhasa. So the mind plus chidabhasa, the reflecting surface and the consciousness which is reflecting that is called jiva, which is you. So the jiva is a combination of reflecting surface and the reflection. See, you cannot separate out the reflection from the mirror. If your face is there in the mirror, you cannot separate out the face from the mirror. They are one. Like that, jiva becomes one with the mind. The chaitanya, the consciousness, reflected consciousness becomes one with the mind. Okay. So now the challenge of spirituality is the chidabhasa, reflected consciousness, has to understand I am really sakshi. And sakshi is Brahman. This understanding has to happen. Otherwise, it will identify with the reflection, mirror. Whatever is happening in the mirror, it starts thinking it's happening in me. So the mirror shows the body, mirror shows the world. So the chidabhasa also gets associated with the body and says, I am the body. Now, how do you stop this reflection? You have to break the mirror. Breaking the mirror is not a solution. You cannot break the mirror because you cannot break the mind. So that's where the importance of buddhi, intellect. Using your intellect, you have to separate out what is consciousness and what is matter. What is chidabhasa and what is matter? What is chaitanyam? What is matter? This is called viveka. Intellect only. Buddhi. Mind, buddhi. Mirror is the buddhi, intellect. So using your intellect only, sharpened intellect, you have to separate out what is matter and what is consciousness. This is called Atma Anatma Viveka. So for example, the jiva sees the body and says, I am the body. So Atma Anatma Viveka is okay. You have to inquire, is body really consciousness? Body is inert because body I can see. So I am consciousness. I am Sakshi, you have to think. So then the intellect, the thoughts are there in the mind. So the thoughts are changing constantly. But I don't change. I am doesn't change. That's why I am Sakshi. Thoughts are not me. Like that, you have to discriminate using the intellect. In this way, you can separate out reflection from the mirror. This is the only way you can separate out reflection from the mirror logically, not physically. Okay. So what some people do is stop the thoughts in the mind. That means make the mind blank. That means there is no mirror. So then chidabhasa has merged with the consciousness, but there's no learning. Understanding has not happened in the intellect. So for the understanding to happen, you have to use the discrimination. What I am not, what I am not, what I am not. Neti, neti, neti. Yeah. They're shut in the mind. Okay? So this discrimination is what makes a difference. So this I call it as mirror prakriya, or prakriya means a process. So you can think everything is a mirror for the consciousness. Okay? So when I see the world, world is a mirror for consciousness because it's reflecting the consciousness. Everything in the world is reflecting consciousness. Okay? For example, when I see sun, I'm seeing the consciousness reflect on the sun. Awareness. My awareness is falling on the sun. Through my eyes, awareness goes, or consciousness goes and falls on the sun. So I have sun consciousness. So when I say sun, it is sun consciousness. When I see the moon, it's a moon consciousness. When I see the flower, flower consciousness. So every object in the world becomes a mirror for consciousness. So as long as you understand it's a mirror, so you say this is a mirror and I am consciousness. But if you forget that it's a mirror, you start giving importance to the object. You give importance to the mirror. So you have to separate out the reflection from the mirror. Every object in the world is a mirror for consciousness. The world is a mirror for consciousness. Atma.
Guruji.
Yes.
If the same consciousness is reflecting on every object, then why is the objects different? Like, why does it look different for us?
Yeah, I'll tell you why the objects are different, right? So the consciousness is same. But through instrument through which the reflection takes place is different. Eyes. Okay. See, the eyes are sensing. Eyes are organs for sensing. Okay. So when I sense through the eyes, the object has some certain shape. Okay. So now here we are not asking whether the object has, there is a called object or not. There is an object outside, which has a form. Because I see through the eyes, or I sense through the touch, I get a different experience. So when I say reflection, I am seeing through the eyes, the consciousness is reflecting the object, I sense through the eyes. Different sense organs define what I see, what I experience. Okay. So now for your question, why there are different objects there out there, Shiva, in your dream, in your deep sleep, there are no objects. But in your dream, you see a forest, a tree, and everything. Correct? So where did this forest come? Where did this tree come from? Where did the tiger in the forest came from? They are projected by the mind. Okay, they are there in your memory, impression. Similarly, the world of objects is there in the impression of the universal consciousness. They are projected and experienced through sense organs. Because they are objects which are present in the universal consciousness, they have different objects and different forms. And when you see through the eyes, you see the reflected consciousness. Does that answer your question, Shiva?
Yes, Guruji.
Okay.
Guruji, is it like the electricity that flows? The electricity is same, but then it can be like in the fan, it can spin around, or light, it will give light bulb. So is it like that?
There are two analogies here. First analogy is in dream, okay? When you are dreaming, the dream world is projected, right? Why there is a world outside? Because in your dream, let's say forest is there, tree is there, everything is there. So where did the forest come from? It is there in your memory. It got projected during the dream. Mind, what was there in the memory, got projected, and you are experiencing it. There's a projection and experiencing, correct? There's no forest or tree outside. There's a projection happening with the mind and experiencing happening through the mind. So similarly, There is no world outside. Okay, whatever world outside is there is a projection by the mind, not universal mind. And you are experiencing that projection in the form of Bangalore, city, your house, your family. What exactly happens in the dream state happens in the waking state also. Right? But when the object is there, okay, the object is seen because there's a reflected consciousness there. Chidabhasa. For example, let's take my hand. Okay. So is light in front of my eyes? There's light, but my eyes cannot see the light without a blocking. The blocking. So if I put my hand, I can see my hand. In reality, I'm not seeing the hand. I'm seeing the reflected light on the hand. Okay. But I forget the reflected light and think the importance of the hand. Similarly, am I seeing the reflected light on the hand? In reality, awareness is coming. Awareness or consciousness is flowing from my eyes, reflecting on the hand and the light. And I'm seeing that. Actually, I'm seeing the reflected consciousness on my hand.
Yeah.
When I see the flower, I'm seeing flower consciousness. When I see the tree, I'm seeing tree consciousness, right? The tree is just a name and form. And how did the name and form come? Because of projection by the mind. So the consciousness is Brahman. Whatever I am seeing in the world, actually I am seeing Brahman only. And Brahman is myself. I am seeing myself in the form of tree. I am seeing myself in the form of sun. I am seeing myself in the form of a building. So let us take the dream analogy again.
In the Prabhuji, one question.
I'll just complete then ask the question. Okay. In my dream, I see a tiger. Actually, I am seeing myself in the form of tiger. In reality, in dream, I am seeing a tree. In reality, I am seeing myself in the form of tree in the dream. Similarly, the waking state, whatever I am seeing myself in various forms. Atma alone is not a physical body, Prabhu, the consciousness, Atma. Atma itself is seen in various forms. So in other words, only God alone is there. Brahman alone is there within and without. So this is called Darpana Prakriya because you have to remember everything is a mirror. And I give some practical examples. Okay. If you see your boss, you'll get tensed up. Remember, boss is nothing but a mirror for your consciousness. And smile. In front of the mirror, you're supposed to smile. Remember, you look at your husband and remember that husband is nothing but a reflection mirror for you. Reflection for consciousness. Look at your wife and wife is nothing but mirror for consciousness, mirror for you. Everywhere you are seeing yourself in the reflection, as reflection. Self means Atma, which is Chaitanyam, which is consciousness. So is this understanding clear?
Gurudeva?
Yes.
Gurudeva, the Sakshi is the one which is throwing light on the Chidabhasa. That is mirror. That is Chidabhasa and Jiva is the mirror.
No. Mind is the mirror. Mind is the mirror. Buddhi, intellect is the mirror. Intellect, Buddhi is the mirror.
Buddhi is the mirror. So by you, as you said, by using a discrimination, where is the discrimination in the mirror only?
Okay. So first let's Sakshi is the light. Sakshi is the sun, right? I showed the sun. Is the Sakshi is the light. Sakshi is the self, Atma. From the Sakshi, the light of the self comes, Atma Jyoti. Awareness spreads. So the awareness needs a reflecting surface. buddhi,
yes,
intellect. The moment awareness, the what you call as the light of the self falls on Atma Jyoti, the mirror called mind or buddhi, there is a reflection. The reflection is called Chidabhasa.
Okay.
Okay. Reflected light is called Chidabhasa. Yes. A sun is there. Reflection of sun is there in the water. Okay. The reflection is called Chidabhasa. Like reflection of Sakshi in the mind, Chidabhasa.
Yes.
Now, can you separate out the reflection from the mirror?
No.
No, no?
Yeah.
You cannot do. Because reflection can exist if there's a mirror. If there's no mirror, there's no reflection.
Yes.
Right? The entire the reflection now, Chidabhasa, is also intelligent because it comes from Sakshi. The reflection also, reflection of sun has the properties of sun only. The bright.
Yes.
Right? So reflection of Sakshi has also properties of Sakshi. Intelligence.
Hmm.
But the reflection does not know I am the reflection. Reflection identifies with the mirror. Anything happening in the mirror, it says it is happening to me.
Hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Let us say, for example, there's a pain in the body. There's a pain. A body has a reflection, Chidabhasa. So there, Chidabhasa will say, I have pain. I am in pain. It identifies with the body rather than the Atma. The Sakshi.
Yes.
Correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Now, how to remove this reflection? You want liberation. Liberation associated with the body or mind. Then mirror, which is breaking the mirror, is not possible.
Yes.
In deep sleep, the mirror is not there. In deep sleep, mind is not there.
Yes.
That's why there's no reflection. At that time, Jiva has merged with the Atma, Sakshi only. In deep sleep.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Right? All in sleep. But in the waking state, we logically understand what's happening, logically, with jnana. Then we should separate out. Discrimination we have to do. How we want to do discrimination? Chidabhasa and buddhi, they are one unit. That's called Jiva.
Okay.
Right? They have become one unit.
Yes.
Now the Chidabhasa will use the buddhi, intellect, to discriminate. Okay, who am I? Who am I not? Right? It'll say, okay, I am able to see the world. I'm not the world. World is my mirror. I'm seeing the reflection in the world. So it'll say, okay, am I able to feel the body? Yes. So body is the mirror. I am seeing the reflection, Chidabhasa. So can I see the thought? Yes. The thoughts are not me. Neti, neti. I am the Sakshi. Like that, you have to separate logically.
Gurudeva, this logic, now you are giving us the logic. That is, did we have this logic or now the Guru is giving the logic, we are taking it from you?
You had right? All magic in your life, no logic at all. So your life learned magic, right? The day you are born, in within 15 days, you have learned that you are Sheetal.
Yeah.
And you learned that you are a girl. Okay, then you learned that you have to get married. So you have children. So whole of logic, whole wrong logic you learn from the society, on the right logic can be given by Vedanta and Guru.
Yes. Right. So the intelligence, that is the logic, the buddhi is already a part of Chidabhasa because it is already given through the Sakshi as Chidabhasa.
No, intellect is there. Intellect is a matter. It's the reflecting surface. Chidabhasa is the reflection.
Yes. Yes.
This reflecting surface, reflection becomes one unit.
Hmm.
Logically separate. This logical separation is called Viveka, discrimination.
Yeah, this Viveka is there in the Sakshi only.
No, no.
From where is
Chidabhasa is reflection of Sakshi, no? Chidabhasa
yes.
has become one with the mind. The mind is
yes.
the right. That instrument has to be properly used by Chidabhasa to understand I am Sakshi.
So that Viveka is there in Chidabhasa only. It will use it to know itself.
No, no. Viveka is not there in Chidabhasa. Viveka is given through the teaching. Viveka is discrimination. How to discriminate?
Okay. So this teaching what you are giving, I mean, it is coming from externally. That is, it is coming from the world, I can say, or what?
It is coming from Upanishad and Guru.
So it is apart from the world.
No, no. Already the world teaching is already there. No, world teaching is already, the intellect is already corrupted. No.
Already there. Yes.
It is already corrupted and already you are convinced that you are Sheetal, you are a woman.
Huh.
You behave like this. All that conviction is there. No, that's already given by the world.
Yes.
So you understand your Atma.
Yes.
How you understand your Sakshi. For that, a logic is required. That logic comes from the Vedanta and it comes from the teaching of Guru. So it is nothing but repairing the logic in the intellect, repairing the corruption in the intellect.
Yes.
Right? For whom is the teaching? For the Chidabhasa, it's the teaching. Intellect is the instrument.
Yes. Yes.
Prabhuji.
Yes.
Prabhuji, is Darpana Prakriya finding the source of the mind?
Darpana Prakriya is understanding that everything in the world is a reflecting surface for the Chaitanyam, consciousness.
Okay.
When I am seeing anything in the world, actually I say there's a coffee, there's a table, there's a chair. Actually, I am seeing the Chaitanyam in the form of table.
Okay.
I am seeing Atma in the form of table.
Okay. Prabhuji, and one more question. For consciousness, you told the world is very small, but consciousness is infinite, no? Then why is it like you had told in some video, it's just like some image in the consciousness you told. But the consciousness is infinite, no, Prabhuji?
Consciousness is definitely infinite. So what is the question?
Prabhuji, so why is it only a small picture? Why can't it be a big picture? Because this consciousness is infinite.
Consciousness is infinite. Infinite. You have a big paper. Does not mean that you have to write a big picture on that. You whatever picture you write, that's all.
Yeah.
Huh? So. Right. You write your. You go to your school. No question paper. You have to write answer paper. You write now. Right.
Yeah.
The answer there for five sheets they give. You have to write all the five sheets or two sheets answers are complete. You can write sufficient.
We should complete how much they give totally. We should complete so that we'll get attempt.
Then there will be another five more sheets empty. So you want to fill up that also.
If the question is if the answer is very big, we'll use those 5 pages.
No, then still another 5 pages I'll give you. Will you write that?
No, because it will be if in 5 pages also it's not sufficient, we'll use that 5 pages.
Right. So the world is sufficient for the consciousness to understand itself. It is a small portion, sufficient for that.
Okay.
Guruji.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, is there more presentation or should I stop and again start?
Yeah, no question has anybody else has questions?
Guruji, one nimsha.
Yes, Kathy.
Iga neevu torisidralla darpana prakriye. Adralli iga chidabhasadinda first world anna torisibittu aamele aa world alli pratiyondu jeevanu ondannu nodutte anta torisidre adinna swalpa sulabha agutta artha agakke anta.
ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸೋಣ.
ನಾನು ಯಾತಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಶೀತಲ್ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ ಗುರು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂತು, ಹೊರಗಡೆಯಿಂದ ಬಂತ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ
ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್
ಅನ್ನ ತೋರಿಸಿದಾಗ ಒಬ್ರಿಗೊಬ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗುರುನು ಆ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿಯಿಂದ ಬಂತು ಆ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ. ಸೊ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಗುರುವಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೆ ವಿದ್ಯೆ ಬಂತು ಅಂತ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ.
ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿದ್ಯೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಎರಡು
ವರ್ಲ್ಡಿಂದಾನೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.
ವರ್ಲ್ಡಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ,
ಅದು ತನ್ನ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್
ಇದೆ ನನಗೆ ಇದೆ.
ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ, ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್.
ಎಸ್.
ಓಕೆ,
ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಕಾತ್ಯಾನಿ ಜಿ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಗುರುದೇವ.
ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನೋ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್. Right? The bondage and liberation is only in Maya. Both Jnana and Ajnana, both are in Maya.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes. Yes,
if Atma is really bonded, then you cannot get out.
Yes. Now that you were saying that dream analogy, no? I was just about to ask it in a different way when Kathayani ji just clarified this with you. I was about to ask that, see, now I am in a dream world, I am dreaming. But to come out of this, there has to be someone who has to tell me that, get up, you are asleep, and you are not this, you are not that. So that person will also be in the dream only, who will come and awake me.
No, person will come into the dream. Person is not in the dream.
he has to come into my dream. So you guru, are coming.
Guru is one who is not in the dream, but guru appears in the dream.
Yes, so Upanishads, Vedantas are in the, they are appearing in the world, but they are not of the world.
They are not of the world.
Yes. Yes, yes, okay. Gurudeva, thank you.
Okay,
clear.
So, Lata, you can stop this. So this will be about Darpana Prakriya.